Good morning, friends. It's Teresa from Star Stylist Homestead. So today, I was looking through my book. Tons of stuff in here, but the only thing is it's like all the cakes, or a lot of the cakes, are from box cakes. I wanted homemade, but it's okay. It's okay because I found a lot of different things. And I made a banana bread last year around the holiday time. And I found this one in here and I said, oh, that sounds pretty good. So I'm going to try their banana bread. So I think I have everything ready. So let me bring you down here. I want to see if I can. Yeah, I don't think I can. I was trying to get this so that you could see me and what I was doing, but I don't think that's going to work. So let's just get you down here first. You don't need to see me. Okay, what we're going to do is stir together. I'm doubling this. I'm making two of them. So it's a half cup measuring, and it calls for 1 cup of sugar. So I'm going to put 4 of these. Just my sugar. Okay, and our milk, remember I'm doubling this, so this calls for 4 tablespoons, which is 1/4 cup. I'm going to put 1/2 cup of milk. And my eggs were not at room temperature, so I put them in warm water. So let's crack these eggs. I have 2 here. Calls for 1. Alexa, volume down. Okay, those are both good. So I'm going to put those right in there. And then, boy, for somebody who doesn't use salt very much, I'm constantly running out in this. All right, and this calls for 1/2 teaspoon of salt. I grabbed 1/2 teaspoon, so I'm going to put 2 of these. Yes. And then we're just going to mix this all together. I decided to do it in this because I'm using my mixer. So I was going to say no sense dirty in another bowl, but I already mashed my bananas too, so the bowl was dirty. Okay, so I mixed that. Get the eggs going. Now, put that in there. I'm going to bring you over here with me to the stand mixer. Okay, close to 1 stick of butter. I had to soften it a little. So I'm going to put both my sticks of butter in here. Those bananas smell so good. I purposely picked up bananas yesterday that were overripe so that I could do this. Okay. Okay, now I'm just going to put this on. And we're going to get that going. Let's get that going. I'll grab my other stuff. Okay. It calls for 3 to 4 mashed bananas. I did 8. They were like medium bananas, but I don't want them so mashed that it's liquid. I left them a little chunky. Who doesn't like biting into a piece of banana bread with that banana, right? Okay, we'll get that going. And then we're gonna add our bananas. Let's bring this down. They're gonna be mashed anyway. So I had frozen my last banana bread. I made a couple and I froze one. and I decided to send it to my brother and sister-in-law after they went home. You know, after being sick for a month and a half, I said, let me send them. I sent them my banana bread and I think my Portuguese bread and a whole bunch of different stuff. And they said, oh my God, that was amazing. I said, yeah. So hopefully this one's just as good. I keep looking over this side. Sorry, my camera's over there. Okay, as that's going, I'm going to do my baking soda, cinnamon, and baking powder. Half a teaspoon. So we need a teaspoon. Calls for a half a teaspoon, and I'll have the recipe below, guys. So I'm going to put 1 teaspoon baking soda. Calls for 1 teaspoon of baking powder, so I'm going to put 2. There's 1. Not going to use that one again because I got dipped in my cinnamon. Calls for a half a teaspoon, so I'm going to put 2 of these because that's the half. And a half a teaspoon of vanilla. My vanilla. Yeah. Measure, friends, measure. Okay, and then our flour. I have it all ready, 4 cups, calls for 2. So I am not gonna do that. I'm gonna do it slowly. Otherwise, look, just 1/4 cup at a time. Smells so good. Oh, look. You're looking at the back of my head. Sorry, guys. I'll just edit this until this is all in. Hey! Hey! Chill! You're attacking my angel over there. Okay, 4 cups. Now I'm going to turn it up. I'm going to let that go. And what I have here, I decided to use pecans. I had whole pecans, so I just put 2 cups in a bag and pound them out with my meat mallet. I left some of them a little bigger than others because I like to taste the nuts. Now let me go and stop those cats from attacking her. I'll be right back. Alrighty, friends, check this out. That's some light, huh? So now, I am just going to add all these nuts in here. Get them combined, and it's done. That's good enough. Let's grab this. Boy, these are not good if you don't have a lot of power behind you. I'll tell you that. Okay, let's bring you over here. All right, friends. This, I'm just gonna mix it because I took that flour off the top there and couple sprinkles there. My oven is preheated to 350. I'm getting down at the bottom just in case that thing didn't mix it well. So just make sure you do that. Oh, that smells amazing. I have my 2 pans here. I'm gonna spray them really good. We don't don't want no sticky. This actually looks like it might be enough for three. Let's see. Wow. This is a lot. It doesn't say that it's more than two. Lordy. All right, friends. These are my things, my breads. And I had a lot left. So I went and got one of my smaller pans. And I'm going to do three of them. Because you're only supposed to fill them about two-thirds full. And I don't have enough for another, big pan. So I'm going to do two and a half. I probably could have used one of my smaller ones. That's all right. I'll have to watch this one. And another thing with this book, as much as I like it, they don't give you very many directions. They tell you what to mix, and that's about it. Yeah, see, this is small. My hands are clean, I promise. All right. It's going to bake on. All right, friends. Now we're going to put it in the oven for 30 to 40 minutes. So, let me get the oil off the sides of those pans. And I think what I'm going to do is a cinnamon sugar topping right before they're done. Just to give it some crispiness. So, here we go. I am going to put it for 25 minutes because of that other one. No, I'm going to do it 20 minutes. And then we'll just add more time for the other ones. So, I'll bring you back. But before I go, I just wanted to let you guys know I am doing okay. I know I haven't been on. I've been really super tired lately. I am just waiting until the second for this surgery. I feel like a teenager. I'm telling you. I know TMI for you guys, but I am so crampy all the time. I can't stand it. I'm like, I cannot. And every night my kidney just hurts. And no matter how I sit or lay down or whatever, it just hurts. Uncomfortable. Not painful like the kidney stone, but yeah, it's uncomfortable. So I'm looking forward to the second. But other than that, I'm doing pretty good. Just tired a lot. I've taken a lot out of me. I don't know. I haven't even wanted to cook lately. This is the first thing I've cooked, I think, in a week, other than real quickie stuff. So, yeah, that's what's happening with me right now. Anyway, I've had two phone calls since I started doing this video. So I'm going to let you go. I'm going to clean my mess while that's cooking. And I'll bring you back. I don't know what that first one's going to do. Hopefully, I don't overcook it because it's so small and spread out. But that'll be ours to eat today if I don't burn it. I'll be back. All right, friends. I am back. My house smells amazing. Look at these. Well done. Don't those look wonderful? I put brown sugar and cinnamon on this one. And I said, that's not melting as well. So I used the regular sugar on that one about 10 minutes before it came out. So you see it all on the sides. This popped right out of the oven. This one started sticking on me. I'm like, I wonder why. But anyway, enough of that. I'm going to cut the small one and do a taste test. Oh, look at the inside. Yummy. Of course, I want the outside of it. Mmm. That's good. I got all outside on here. Let me grab a piece. Mm-hmm. I almost forgot. Put a little butter on it. Mmm. Those came out really good. So, there you have it, my friends. They are really good, too. And I like it with the brown sugar on top. No, I wish I did the other two that way. So, there you go, friends. That's my banana bread. I have no idea. I'm going to have to go look and see if I did a video already, but this is a different recipe. So, if I did another one, you can pick. Like and subscribe if you haven't already. I will keep you guys updated on what happens. My pre-op's the 27th and my surgery's the 2nd. So, you guys will know. I'll keep you updated. I love you. Thanks for being here and have a great weekend. Ciao for now.